Today, I'd like to introduce you to a very special friend in the Teach Wonderful classroom. This is our class pet. His name is... Well, maybe I'll show you how it's spelled. It's G-H-O-T-I. How would you pronounce it? Have a moment to think about it and get back to me. So, how did you go? I'm betting you tried goaty, or gahotty, maybe gooty? You might be surprised to learn that our class pet's name, G-H-O-T-I, is actually pronounced fish. That's right, our class fish is named fish. Very original. But how on earth does G-H-O-T-I spell fish? Well, let me explain. Think about these three words, tough, women, and potion. Notice how the letters GH in tough actually sound like an F, tough. Also notice how the O in women actually sounds more like an E. Starting to see it? Lastly, the TI from potion actually makes a SH sound, similar to words like motion and lotion. Therefore, GH O-T-I spells fish. Well, not really. This little spelling trick is just a bit of fun, but it only works because many of the sounds we use in English have lots of different ways of spelling them. As an example, the consonant sound K has at least five different spelling choices. C, K, Q, CK, and CH. That's a lot of choices for one sound. Today, I'm going to introduce you to a special alphabet you might have seen if you've looked up a word in the dictionary or online. It's called the International Phonetic Alphabet, or IPA, and it's been around since 1886. These are the symbols for the consonant sounds, some of which we use in our regular alphabet. And these are the symbols for the vowel sounds. Below each symbol is an example of that sound being used in a word. Interestingly, our G-H-O-T-I spelling trick would not work using this alphabet because each of the sounds has only one possible symbol. That's right, one sound, one symbol. Today, I'm going to give you a crash course in writing down words using the International Phonetic Alphabet. The most important thing to remember when using IPA is to listen to the individual sounds within a word instead of thinking how the word might be spelt. Let's try to write the word wash using IPA. The word wash has four letters, but only three sounds. The consonant sound w, the vowel sound o, and the consonant sound sh. If we look at our consonant sounds on our IPA chart, the first symbol is pretty easy. We just use a standard W from our regular alphabet. The next sound is a little trickier. Let's look at the vowel sounds on our IPA chart. Even though it uses the letter A in the English spelling, the sound is actually the O sound from the word orange. So in our IPA version, we write down this strange upside-down A symbol. The last sound is another consonant sound. It's the sh sound from the word short. In this case, we use this strange-looking S symbol. That's it. Three sounds and three symbols. One more example. Let's try the word jelly. Jelly has four sounds. J, E, L, and E. The J sound is represented by this weird symbol that looks a bit like D3 from the word judge. The E sound in IPA is represented by a standard E from the word egg. Let's write it down. The L sound is a bit trickier. Even though we use two L's in our English spelling, we only use one symbol in IPA Because there's only one sound. Remember, one sound, one symbol. So in this case, we simply use a lowercase l. Finally, the e sound, often found on the end of words, is represented by an I. And that's it, the word jelly written in IPA. Now it's your turn. Your challenge today is to have a go at using the International Phonetic Alphabet. You can download a copy from the description below this video. For today's challenge, I've given you a list of words to decode from IPA back into English, and a selection of words for you to transcribe. You might even try to write a secret message to someone using IPA. For today's task, you can also use a dictionary if you want to check the accuracy of your answers. Best of luck with today's IPA challenge. We'll see you next time. Hey there! If you like what we do here at Teach Wonderful, make sure to subscribe to our channel. You'll also find plenty of amazing teaching ideas, student worksheets, and merch over at teachwonderful.com. Thanks for watching. We'll see you soon.